Hey guys, Boss here. Today I'm going to talk about the read operation in DynamoDB table. There are two types of read operation in DynamoDB, the query and scan operation. They allow you to fetch a collection of data. Scan and query are two very basic types of operation in DynamoDB, but they are very important. You must understand the difference. Let me talk about the scan operation first. When you're using scan operation, means that you're scanning through the whole table or index. If you want to find a particular collection of items by the scan operation, you usually use it together with filter. It means that you're applying some filter conditions to the scanned result. So imagine if you have millions of items in your tables, it will be quite inefficient if you apply the filter condition for this large data set. Therefore, we have the second type of read operation, the query operation. Query is based on the primary key to find items. This means that we are applying some key conditions when you are using the query operation. This means that we can directly look for the items in certain partition. So the lookup is more direct. Therefore, in general, the query operation is more efficient than the scan operation. Let's take a look at the following simplified example. It is a very simple game leaderboard table. It stores the game player information and also the top score for each game of the player. We have a global secondary index for this table. We are using S key as a partition key and the top score as a short key. Actually, I have explained this table design in my previous video. If you are interested in the table design, you can take a look on that video. And now I will start to do a demo based on this table. My demo will be divided into four parts. I will first create the DynamoDB table by using some script. I will execute some AWS CLI command to create the table. And then I will batch write some items to the tables. And then I will start to do the scan command and also the query command. You can follow me to do the demo, but you need to install and config the AWS CLI. If you don't know how to install and config the AWS CLI, I have another video to teach you how to download, install and config the AWS CLI. You can go back to see that video. Okay, let's start the hands-on. I have mentioned before, you can follow another video to config and install the AWS CLI. I have put the video link in my video description. One more thing you need to know, that after you have created an IAM user, you must add the Amazon DynamoDB access permission for that user. So you must go to IAM dashboard and then add this permission. I have added DynamoDB full access for that users. This is a very important thing you need to know when you config the AWS CLI. After you have configured the AWS CLI, and then you can start to do the demo. First step is to create a DynamoDB table. Now I go to the DynamoDB console, and I show you the script to create the table. Here are all the scripts that I will run for this demo. For the first script, this is the create table.sh. It is a shell script. I actually run two commands, the AWS DynamoDB create table and update table. For the first command, it is create table. We just accept the table name, and we should define the key. We use user ID and the SK as the primary key, and we also provide the throughput, RCU, and WCU. The second command is For updating the table, we provide a table name. For this command, actually we are creating the global secondary index. So we need to provide the attributes, the key attributes name. We use SK and the top score as the key attributes, as the primary key. And we can see the detail of the global secondary index in this gsi.json. Let's go to the see the gsi.json. This is a JSON file which describes the global secondary index. We should provide the index name, the key attributes, SK. And we use SK as the partition key and top score as the short key. We also provide the throughput, the projection. Let me run this command for you. I just type. createTable.sh. It will then run the two command for you. Okay, the command has run successfully. Okay, now let's go back to the AWS management console and refresh the screen. We can see that the leaderboard table has been created and the status is active. Let's click inside to see the detail of the table. We can see that the global secondary index is creating because it takes some time for the GSI to create. The GSI is active now. The partition key is SK and the short key is top score. Table, we can see that the partition key is user ID and the short key is SK. Okay, let's go to the second step. We will now add some item to this leaderboard table. Let me show you the script first. For the second step, I will run the create batch item.sh. This is also a shell script. It will run the batch write item command. This is also a AWS CLI command. You can see that I separately run three command here because this batch write item command have some limitation. It only allow you to write 25 items per execute. Let's take a look to this input-write.json file. Actually, this JSON file contains a series of put requests. For the first put request, it is the player info details. It stores the user ID, the email, and also the location, the username. But for the second put request, it is for the score information. You can see that it is for the FIFA, for the top score of the FIFA game for that player. And the third request is the top score for the NBA game. Let me run this command for you. Create batch item. It will turn the JSON object, which is the unprocessed item, which is empty. This means that all the items has been put into the leaderboard table successfully. Okay, let's go back to the AWS management console. This time we go to explore items. You can see that all the item has been put into the leaderboard table. We can click one of them to see the details. Actually, it is a JSON file. Okay, let's go to the third step. Now I will use the scan command to find all the top score for the game FIFA. Let's go back to the code. This time I will show you the scanfilter.sh shell script. It actually runs the scan command. I have to input the table name as parameter, a filter expression. You can see that it is condition for the scan. Colon V1 is the placeholder, and we need to provide the expression attributes values, and I put the filter value in this JSON file. Let's go to see the details of this JSON file. Actually, it just specifies the colon V1. It is the value filter, S is the string type. Let me run the command for you. It lists all the top score for the game FIFA. Now we go to the fourth step, the last step. I will use the query command to do the same thing. To find all the top score for the game FIFA, I go back to the code. You see that the command is very similar. I open the script query by gsi.sh. This time, we will query by the global secondary index. We need to input the table name as parameter, leaderboard, and also we need to input the index name, sk top score index. And we need to specify a parameter no scan index forward. With this parameter, the item will list out in descending order of the top score. We also need to provide a key condition, sk equal to colon v1, and an expression attribute value, which is the same JSON file filter value.json, which specifies the colon v1 equal to FIFA. And now I run the command. I open the terminal and I type query by GSI. We can see that the result is pretty the same, except that the top score is arranged in descending order. And because we don't have too much data, too much items in this leaderboard table, so you will not see the performance difference. Okay, now you see that we have two ways to retrieve the data from DynamoDB. One is using the scanning, and another method is using the query. I hope that you now understand the difference between scan and query. That's it. If you like this video, please share this video and subscribe to our channel. Bye bye.